Welk and the Champagne Music Makers in specially selected shows for public television.
And isn't that something? That's Lawrence's resort down there. I think you'd have to say that he's come a long, long way from the little sod farmhouse in North Dakota where he was born. Lawrence and I are alike in so many ways. I was born on a farm too, but in South Dakota, between Webster and Roslyn. Both of us came from poor families, but very loving, very religious families. Both of us learned to play the accordion when we were still quite young. And both of us love to entertain, bring a little happiness to the folks. I've been with Lawrence ever since I joined the band in Chicago in 1950. That means that by the time we went off the air in 1982, we'd been together for 32 years. And you just don't find that kind of loyalty in show business very often. The show you're going to see now was a celebration of our 25th year on television. And as it happens, it was my 25th anniversary too. Lawrence planned a little surprise for me, as you'll see. So let's go back now to 1975 and our silver anniversary.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Another opening, another show. In Philly, Boston, or Baltimore. A chance for stage folks to say hello. Another opening of another show. The overture is about to start. You cross your fingers and hold your heart. It's curtain time and away we go. Another opening of another show.
Yes, my friends, another opening, another show. A very special silver anniversary show. It marks the beginning of our 25th year on television. Our thanks to you good people for keeping us going all of these years. So many people often ask me, Lawrence, where do you find all the pretty and talented girls for your show? Who auditions them? What a silly question. That happens to be my job, a very pleasant job. I think when you see them, you'll agree, at the age of 72, there's nothing wrong with my eyesight. Let's meet some of the most beautiful girls in the world, starting out with our lovely champagne lady, Norma Zimmer. And our gorgeous redhead from Brigham Young University, Sandi Griffith. Gentlemen, Cissy King from Albuquerque, New Mexico, a queen of any ballroom. My lovely, vivacious Italian daughter-in-law, Tanya. From the heart of Dixie, our country gal, Ava Barber, from Knoxville, Tennessee. Ralna English from Lubbock, Texas, with a voice as big and beautiful as her native state. Our charming little señorita from Mexico by way of Escondido, Anacani. Lovely and talented Gail Farrell from Durand, Oklahoma, and very proud to be called Enoki. Charming little singer, dancer, and actress Mary Lou Metzger from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Oh, look at there, no partner. Will one of you people from the audience come and dance with her, please? Okay, I'll do it. Folks, am I glad I left the farm. Well, we're celebrating another silver anniversary this evening. This next gentleman joined our musical family just 25 years ago. During this time, he has developed himself into one of the greatest accordionists in the world, one of the most respected musicians in his profession, and a man who dedicates his life to helping others. Our happy Norwegian Myron Floren playing a Bob Ballad arrangement of the Carnival of Venice, George Cate. And we happen to be sharing a 25th anniversary. We have a very special gift for your new garden. Girls, bring it in.
Oh, my goodness.
Myron, what an appropriate gift, a silver hoe. Ow!
Oh,
there's my head. You decided. And the inscription is, to Myron Floren on his 25th anniversary from Lawrence and the Champagne Music Makers.
Isn't that one, you know, with this to help, the next 25 are even going to be greater, you know?
Oh, look at that.
That really was a surprise. I don't know who thought of a silver hoe, but it was a very cute idea. And as a matter of fact, I still have it. I can't say that I've ever actually used it. It's too pretty. But it sure brings back a lot of happy memories. Now it's my pleasure to introduce the ever-lovely, ever-young Norma Zimmer. Our beautiful champagne lady sings one of her favorite songs, Yesterday.
Beautiful. One of the nicest things about our television career has been the privilege of having this lovely lady with our musical family. For years, we've been introducing these next two performers as America's number one young dance couple. Well, folks, they still are. Cissy and Bobby. Bobby, Wonderful, wonderful. One for each of them. Here's our charming little Mexican senorita, Anacani. You will love her.
Buenas noches. Means good evening to you all. It's impossible. Tell the sun to leave the sky. It's just impossible. It's impossible. Ask a baby not to cry. It's just impossible. Can I hold you closer to me and not feel you going through me? Split the second that I never think of you. Oh, how impossible. Somos novios, mantenemos un cariño limpio y puro. Como todos, procuramos el momento más oscuro. Besos, recordar de qué color son los cerezos, sin hacer más comentarios, somos novios. Para hablarnos, para darnos el más dulce de los besos, recordar de qué color son los cerezos, sin hacer más comentarios, somos novios. It's impossible, somos novios.
Lawrence found Anacani right here in Escondido. And she was just a lovely little girl when she started in 1972. But I think you'll agree she's grown into a stunningly beautiful woman. She's quite busy on Spanish television these days, as well as appearing in concerts all over the country, and she often appears on the shows I take on the road. Next up is a fellow who's been with the band almost as long as I have, Jimmy Roberts. Jimmy was with us when we were playing at the old Aragon Ballroom on Lick Pier in Ocean Park, California. And after all these years together, I can still say he's got one of the nicest dispositions in the world. No temperament at all, just a plain nice guy. And here he is with some of our pretty girls to sing Speak to Me of Love.
I adore you.
Speak to me of love and say what I'm longing to hear. Tender words of love, repeat them again, I implore you. Speak to me of love and whisper these words to me, dear. I adore you. And say what I'm longing to hear. Repeat them.
wonderful Jimmy Roberts, a fine rendition of this fine love song. It's a pleasure to present a truly fine artist, a real master of the keyboard, Bob Ralston, with his own arrangement of Deep Purple.
Thanks again for another wonderful performance. Here's another song from our brand new 25th anniversary album. And this time we feature America's Sweethearts of Song, Guy and Ralna.
Life too, for I
Guy and Ralna were unquestionably the most popular husband and wife team we ever had on the show. And that particular song was one of their best. It was arranged by one of our top arrangers, Joe Riso, who really outdid himself. That number never failed to stop the show wherever we went on tour. You know, I'm really enjoying the relaxation and peace here because I'm out on the road most of the year. I've cut back a little bit this year. I'm only doing about 150 shows instead of the usual 200. I just finished an engagement at the Norse Kustfest in Minot, North Dakota. My 10th year up there, and some of the folks that entertained with me were the Statler brothers, Barbara Mandrell, and Andy Williams. The folks there really surprised me with this painting in honor of my 10th year. In the upper left-hand corner, you'll see the house on the farm in Day County that I was born and raised in. And on the right, you see my boss for 32 years, two-thirds of my life. I don't know how my poor wife, Berdine, puts up with me because I'm out on the road most of the time. But I guess we must be doing something right because just recently, we celebrated our 44th wedding anniversary. And we have quite a family. We have five daughters, four sons-in-law, seven grandchildren. We've been very, very blessed. Now back to the show, and Arthur Duncan dancing to Never-Ending Song of Love. And Arthur gets a little help from our trio, Sandy, Gail, and Mary Lou, and the great clarinet work by Henry Cuesta.
I've got a never-ending love for you. From now on, that's all I want to do. From the first time we met, I knew I'd sing my never-ending song of love for you. I've got a never-ending love for you. From now on, that's all I want to do. From the first time we met, I knew I'd sing my never-ending song of love for you. After all this time of being alone, we can love one another, feel for each other from now on. Feels so good, I can hardly stand it. Never-ending love for you. From now on, that's all I want to do. From the first time we met, I knew I'd sing my never-ending song of love for you.
Recently, when we played Ava Barber's hometown in Knoxville, Tennessee, the 10,000-seat auditorium was sold out the very first day the tickets went on sale. Yes, they really love this girl. Ava, you're on.
If she brings you happiness, then I wish you the best. It's your happiness that matters most of all. But if she ever breaks your heart,
If the teardrops ever start, I'll be there before the next teardrop falls. Though it hurts to let you go, darling, I want you to know that I'll stand by you if ever you should call. And if I should ever hear that she made you shed a tear, I'll be there before the next teardrop falls. I'll be there anytime dry away every teardrop that you've cried. And if she ever leaves you blue, just remember I love you, and I'll be there before the next teardrop falls. Teardrop falls.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tom Netherton, and you know, out of the last 25 years that the Lawrence Welk Show has been on the air, I've only been with the show for about a year and a half. But it's already proven to be a wonderful experience for me. And one of the great things that's happened, too, with being on the show is a chance to do my very first album. So tonight, I'd like to do a song for you from that album. And, well, it's become very special to me, and I just hope you like it as much as I do.
Flowers still bloom in the springtime. Raindrops still make them grow. Autumn still follows the summer. A child still wishes for snow. Old folks grow tired and leave us, but each day new babies arrive. Someone makes all of this happen. It's so clear that God is alive. Boys to grow up to be soldiers, and wars breed hatred and fear. But wars are started by people who just don't believe God is here. Somehow, some still deny him, saying that God is dead. Yet man has come and man has gone, and still his world lives on and on. His love will survive. Yes, God is alive. Somehow, some still deny him, saying that God is dead. Yet man has come and man has gone, and still his world lives on and on. His love will survive. Yes, God is alive.
As you can tell, Tom meant every word of that song. And he's still very busy today performing on the religious circuit. Did you know that he never sang at all until he was a senior in high school? He tried out for a school musical on a dare and naturally got the part. By the way, girls, he's still tall, still handsome, and still not married. Now here's Lawrence to introduce our next performer.
We've had many letters from the ladies who tell us they like it when we let Ken Dealer sing to them in the audience. So Ken, make the ladies happy.
Thank you, Lawrence. First of all, I'd like to thank my mother, my sister, all my aunts for writing those letters. Just kidding.
Kiss me once, then kiss me twice, then kiss me once again. It's been a long, long time. Haven't felt like this, my dear, since can't remember when. It's been a long, long time. You'll never know how many dreams I've dreamed about you, or just how empty they all seemed without you. So kiss me once, kiss me twice. Oh, I do get it. Kiss me once again. It's been a long, long time.
Has it been a long time?
Kiss me once, then kiss me twice, then kiss me once again. It's been a long, long time.
With the lavender blue here.
Can't have it felt like this, my dear, so you're shaking me up, since can't remember when. It's been a long, long time. You'll never know how many dreams I've dreamed about you, or just how empty they all seemed without you. So kiss me once, kiss me twice, one more time. It's been a long, long time. It's been a long, long time.
Oh, that long.
Take it easy. Take it easy, folks. And those ladies were fighting him all the way. It's my pleasure now to introduce my lovely Italian daughter-in-law, Tanya, with some fine trombone support by Bob Havens.
They heard the breeze in the trees singing weird melodies, and they called back the star to the blues, and from a gem came a wind of a doubt. From a whippoorwill out on a hill, they took a new note, pushed it through a horn till it was worn into a blue note. And then they nursed it, rehearsed it, and gave out Southland gave birth to the blues.
And thank you for two fine grandsons, Kevin Phil, 3 years of age, and Lawrence Walk, the third, 5 years of age. Folks, for 8 months, we've had the Samanska sisters on a training program at our country club village in Escondido. It's a pleasure to present the girls, along with their Polish father and Irish mother.
A place to go so I can be all alone from thoughts and memories, so that when the music plays I don't go back to the days when love was you.
Hold it, young lady, or I should call you mother. When you dance with me, I do the leading. Yes. Try it once more, girls. One, two, three, four.
Yeah.
Well, you can't do a Welk show without a polka, and they were always a lot of fun. The little girl who tagged in on Lawrence was Michelle Szymanski. Lawrence found the girls one time when he was on vacation in Florida, and they were on our show for about 2 years, I believe, before they retired. The last I heard, nearly all of those little girls were married. How time flies. Something else Lawrence and I had in common is a great love for this country. We're both so grateful for the opportunities and freedoms we are privileged to have. Here's the orchestra and chorus with a special tribute. Like the drummer in that number. Wasn't that something? You know, when he did this particular production in Lake Tahoe, it was always a rush to get Lawrence off the stage and out the back of the theater in time to make his entrance through the audience. Well, I think he's had enough time now to get out of that big bass drum. So let's go back to the show for some more heartfelt remarks and America the Beautiful.
As our nation celebrates its 200th birthday, I believe it's a good time for all of us to pause and reflect on our good fortune, the privilege of living in the greatest country in the world. Let us remember to preserve and protect the freedom which many of us take for granted. And let us be thankful for the many blessings we enjoy in a nation which is truly your land and my land.
And friends, I couldn't agree with him more. And I think those words are even more meaningful today. We're lucky to live in this wonderful country. Friends, that's our show for this week. I hope you enjoyed it. I know I certainly enjoyed spending this time with you. Now, please stay tuned for a preview of next week's show. Until we meet again, may God be with you. Bye for now.